गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज माई स्क्वेल एग्रीगेट फंक्शन एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम एग्रीगेट फंक्शंस। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज एग्रीगेट फंक्शन? एग्रीगेट फंक्शन इज द फंक्शन वेयर द वैल्यूज ऑफ मल्टीपल रोज आर ग्रुप टुगेदर टू फॉर्म अ सिंगल समरी वैल्यू। सो दैट्स व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड द एग्रीगेट फंक्शंस, बिकॉज दे फॉर्म अ सिंगल समरी वैल्यूज। एंड सम मेन एग्रीगेट फंक्शंस आर काउंट, सम, एवीजी फॉर एवरेज, मीन फॉर मैक्सिमम मिनिमम वैल्यू एंड मैक्स फॉर मैक्सिमम वैल्यूज। सो दीज आर द सम एग्रीगेट फंक्शंस, काउंट, सम, एवरेज, मिन एंड मैक्स, मिन फॉर मिनिमम एंड मैक्स फॉर मैक्सिमम। एवीजी फंक्शन इज यूज टू काउंट द एवरेज वैल्यू। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, लेट अस टॉक अबाउट मैक्स फंक्शन। एज द नेम सजेस्ट, दिस फंक्शन इज यूज टू रिटर्न द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू इन अ सेट ऑफ वैल्यूज फॉर For an expression. So if you want to find out the maximum value of a set of expression, then for that purpose we used a function named max function. And this aggregate function is useful when we need to find the maximum number, selecting the most expensive product or getting the largest payment of the customer from your table. And two important things regarding to max function, aggregate function. First of all, you cannot use any aggregate functions. Aggregate function always used with select statement, first thing. Second important thing, there is a table named dual, which is a default table. So if you want to make any calculation using aggregate function, you can use a table dual. And if you just don't write the table dual, then by default it is also considered. Third important thing, if there is already a table, existing table in your database, then you can perform such functions such as the max, min, average, count using that table also. So we perform all these tasks related to this. First of all, there is a syntax, complete syntax. First of all, we write a select keyword, after that the name of the function, that is the max in this case. And if you want to find out the distinct value, means we don't want any repetition, then we use a distinct keyword, and then after aggregate expression, that may be a column name or maybe any set of values, and then after from, and then after table names. Here if you want to perform a calculation on the numbers, then you can use table name dual. Otherwise, if you want to perform calculation on a table such like the customers or the employee data or like a student underscore info, that is that table name should be used after that. So let us take an example which gives you a clear idea about that. First of all, parameter explanation. First is aggregate expression. It is called the required expression, and it specifies the column, expression or the formula from which the maximum value will be returned. Second is table names. It specifies the table from where we want to retrieve records, and there must be at least one table listed in the from clause. Third one is where condition. It is optional, so we don't most of the time don't write it. And it is specify the condition that must be fulfilled for the record to be selected. So if there is a particular condition or certain condition is there, then we use where clause. And after that, distinct. It is also optional, and it allows us to return the maximum of the distinct values in the expression. However, it does not affect the max function and produce the same result without using this keyword. So these are the parameters used with this. The parameters are aggregate expressions, table names, where condition, and distinct. Now I think all of them are clear to all of you. Next is MySQL max function example. So first of all, let us take an example which shows the how max function, aggregate function works. So first of all, let us take a table name employees, and that contains the following data. This is a data related to the employee. You can easily see here that these are the columns: name, employee ID, employee name, employee age, city, and the income, and these are the rows. And particular data related to employees called the record, such as at employee ID 101, there is a employee name Peter, whose employee a whose age is 32, who live in New York, and his income is 2 lakh. Okay, so this is a table. Here you can easily see that we use a command select staff from employees. It means all the re information related to the employees here displayed here. A star basically shows complete information regarding to all columns and all rows. So now we have a table employees which have in which there are four columns: employee ID, employee name, employee age, city, and income. And also there are certain rows. So if we want to find out the suppose maximum income of an employee, then we can use max aggregate function here, by which we can easily calculate maximum income. So let us take an example. That is a basic example. So execute the following query that uses the max function to find the maximum income of the employee available in the table. So if you want to find out the maximum income of a table employees, then we just write that statement select, then max, and within the parentheses, just write name of the column. And name of the column is here. You can easily see that income. Income is the name of the column. So we write income here. Okay. Then after, if you want to give a alternative name, then as keyword should be used, and within double quotation sign or double quotation mark, we just write the column name. And here we just write the column name maximum income. You can see the output here. In our output, column name is maximum income. So it is optional if you don't write it. So max income is there. Otherwise, if you give an alternative name, then that alternative name, whatever we give in just after as keyword, will be displayed in the in your answer. So here maximum income is the alternative name, and then after use keyword from, and then table name. Table name is employees here. So table name is employees. So basically, it shows the maximum income of table name employees by using an aggregate function max. So one thing where it should be very clear that we use a aggregate function max here, and within the parenthesis sign we give a parameter value as a name of the column on behalf on which we want to find, we want to perform some calculation. And the here calculation actually here if we want to find out the maximum value, so we just write max income here, maximum income here. So now a statement is select max income as maximum income from employees, and then MySQL max function with where clause. So this is a simple example here. Now I think it is clear to all of you that how to find maximum income of a table name employees, or how to use max aggregate function here. So two important things should be there. First of all, we don't use max function alone. We must use it with select statement. Second thing is there that within the parenthesis sign, we always pass a value on behalf of that we want to find out some calculation we want, or column name of a particular table. So here the column name is income. You can also find out the maximum value of a particular sequence, we will discuss later on in this video. But first of all, we have a table employees, and employees table have certain columns in which one column is income. So if you want to find out the maximum income of employees of table M of an employee using the table employees, then for this purpose we just write select max income as maximum income from employees. Then max function with where clause. Max income functions with where clause. So here we can easily see that where clause is there. So where, as we know that where clause basically used to retrieve a record on the basis of certain conditions there. So actually all things are same as that mentioned in the previous case, but here one thing is one condition is used, and that condition is where employee age is greater than 35. So we have to find out the maximum income where employee age is greater than 35. So that condition is specified with where clause. You can easily see here that that is a part of the that part is same as that of the mentioned in the previous case, but only the one condition is mentioned, and that condition is where employee underscore age is greater than 35. So that is written here. So as you can see on screen, select maximum income as maximum income. Here maximum income is the name of the column which will be displayed on a screen after the execution of that command. And from employees, employees is the name of the table again. And where, after where, we just specify a condition, and its condition is employee underscore age is greater than 35. So this will apply on all those employees who have greater than 35. So here maximum age is find out of all those employee on all those employee who have age greater than 35. So that is the final result after the execution of that statement. So MySQL max function with where clause, that is the second example here. So you can use where clause or without where clause. If you use the max aggregate function without where clause, then this function basically applies to the all rows. And if you use a where clause, then certain condition will be there. And maximum function basically find out the records only based on that certain condition, not for all rows, as you can see on the screen. That is the output. You can see here that where age is 35, then that is the output 1 lakh. So basically this is our original data, and in this case you can easily see that these are the age, and that will be, and the record will be find where age is greater than 35. So only those case income, maximum income will be find out where age is find to be greater than 35, where age is find out greater than 35. And in this case, age is greater than find out is 1 lakh. Next is MySQL max function with group by clause. Max function is always also used by group by clause. So you can you are aware the concept of the group by. If you want to form a group on the basis of particular condition, then group by clause is used. And as you know that group by clause is always used with aggregate functions. So here in this case you can easily see that if you want to form a group on the basis of age, on the basis of particular age, then for that purpose we just try to select employee age, maximum income, employee is the name of the column, and then maximum income, max income, we pass a parenthesis with pass a parameter value within the parenthesis. Here you can easily see that income is the name of the column as maximum income. So maximum income is the name of the column here. From employees, employees is the name of the table. Group by employee age, so we form a group on the basis of employee age. So employee is the name of the employee age is a basically the column. On the behalf of that we form a group here. So after the execution of that statement, after the execution of that statement we get an answer. You can easily see that now group is formed on the basis of the age. So 32, 40, 35 and 45 is there. And now let us see the original table here. That is our original table in which you can easily see that these are the ages: 32, 32, 40, 35, 32, 45, 35, 40, 40, 32, 40 and 45. So after the execution of this statement you can easily see that 32 appears only one time because we form a group. 40 only appears one time because this is the condition to form a group, then 35 and then 45. 45 is there. So employees that have age 32 have maximum income 40,000. That is the final result of this, of the execution of that, of after the execution of that query. Similarly, employees those have age 40 have maximum income 1 lakh, and employees those have age 35 have maximum income 5 lakh, and employees those have age 45 max have maximum income 45,000. So that is the final result after execution of that statement. So that is the statement. So we can say that aggregate functions, especially in this case maximum function, is also used with the group by clause. So when we form a group on the basis of a particular condition and that condition is basically the column name employee age. So we basically form a group on the basis of employee age, and then we find a maximum income related to maximum income on the basis of employee age here. So that is the output. Next is MySQL max function with having clause. As you know that if there is a condition related to a group, then that condition should be mentioned with having clause. So generally we specified a condition with their clause, but when there is a condition related to a group, that condition must be specified with a having clause. So when there is a condition related to a group, that condition should be mentioned with having clause. Now suppose all things are same as that of the previous case, but there is another condition, and the condition is maximum income should be greater than 2 lakh, should be greater than 2 lakh. So what should be done here? We write having clause and just write having max income is greater than equal to 2 lakh. So that is a condition which apply on all the groups, and only those groups are displayed on a screen that have maximum is maximum that have maximum income 2 lakhs only. So simple thing is that having clause is used when we want to apply a condition on a particular group, then having clause should be used there. So all things are same. I think the role of the max function is now clear to all of you. Basically max function find out the maximum value among a particular column, and the column name is income here. But in this case, not only we have to find out the maximum income, but we have to find out the maximum income on the basis of some group, and the form option of group is on the basis of a city, column name city, which is a column name. And there is another condition which must be satisfied, and that condition is maximum income should be greater than or equal to 2 lakhs. So for this purpose we write select city comma max income as maximum income. After as, you all also know that alternative column name, that is column name will be there. Now the answer, in your answer column name is maximum income. So when you just write as, then this provide a column name, otherwise default column name should be there. And then after from employees, and employees is a table name, group by city. So we form a group on the basis of city, column, having max income, having max, having is a having clause, basically contain a condition which is to be satisfied by a group, and the condition is max income is greater than equal to 2 lakhs. So income must be greater than equal to 2 lakhs. So after the execution, you can easily see the here, this is the output. And first of all, you can easily see that two columns names are there, city and maximum income. And why maximum income is there? Maximum income is there because we just write here as maximum income. So otherwise function name should be displayed, but we give a name here, alternative name to our max income function as maximum income. So maximum income column name will be there. And after that, you can easily see that we form a group on the basis of city. So different city names are there. And these cities name are New York, California. Okay, these are the different city names appear only one time because we form a group here. And also there is a condition on a group, and that condition maximum income is greater than 2 lakhs. So you can easily see here that only those groups are displayed which have maximum income greater than 2 lakh. Now our next case is SQL function with distinct clause. So you can also use maximum function with distinct clause. So SQL uses a distinct keyword to remove the duplicate rows from the column name. So if you want to remove duplicate rows from the column name, you must use distinct keyword. And you can easily see here, that is an example. So example, in this example we can easily see that we just pass as income as a parameter and just write distinct keyword there. And distinct keyword basically play a role, and its task is here to find out the unique income. If there is a repetition of an income, then it is considered only as a single time here. So select city max distinct income as maximum income from employees group by city. So we form a group on the basis of city, and table name is employees here, and we take two columns, income and maximum income, but we take distinct income here, means no repetition will be there in case of income. So after the execution, you can see here that is the output. So distinct keyword basically remove the duplicate values. So that is the answer after the execution of that statement, and all things are remain same. You can easily see that name of the column are city and maximum income. And why maximum income? As I told you earlier, that after, as we just write the name of the column maximum income, so instead of max distinct income, maximum income will be there, because we give a column name here, and then we form a group here on the basis of city. So different cities names are there, and maximum incomes are also there. Now next, MySQL function is subqueries example. So sometimes it is required to use the subquery for returning the maximum value in a table. In that case, we use the following query. You can easily see here, select star from employees, where employee age is equal to select maximum employee age from employees. So that is the example of SQL functions using subquery. The subquery first find the maximum age of the employee from the table, and then the main query, auto query, returns the result of age being equal to the maximum age returned from the subquery and other information. You can easily see that first of all, this part is going to be executed, and this statement that select maximum employee age from employee. So first of all in table employees, maximum age should be find out, and whatever is the maximum age, whatever is the maximum age of an employee, that is to be assigned to employee underscore age. And now we have a query, select star from employees, where employee underscore age, suppose employee underscore age value, what we find out after the execution of subquery is suppose 32. So now our query is select star from employees, where age is where employee age is equal to 32. So that outer query will be executed then. In this case, there are two queries. One is main query or outer query, and that then second is subquery. When there are two subqueries, then when there are two queries, one is main query and the second is subquery, then first of all subquery will be executed, and whatever is the result of the subquery, that is the becomes the input for the auto query. In this case, you can easily see that here employee age is equal to select maximum employee age from employees, that is rounded by a circle, is a subquery. So first of all, this query is executed, so we get a basically a maximum age out of this, because you can easily see here maximum employees age from employees can be find out, and that is a number of course. And now we have auto query, and that auto query is select star from employee, where employee age is equal to, there is a certain value, suppose 32 or 35, whatever it is. So on the behalf of that, result will be displayed, and star is there, so all columns will be displayed. So all columns are employee ID, employee name, employee age, city, income. So four columns are there, so you can find out the result after that. So that is the final result. So the main thing is, first of all, inner query will be executed, after that outer query will be executed. And inner query will give the input for the auto carry. That is the main purpose of using this statement. So that is the concept of a MySQL function at a sub MySQL max function in subquery. And at last, one more important thing is there. If you want to find out the maximum number in a given sequence or in a given data set, then you can also use this statement. First of all, at prompt, write select, 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 and then you just give max and give the value 1, 2, 3. So after the execution of that statement, answer will be 3. Here you can easily see that we don't give a table name here. So by default table name is dual. So you can write this statement as this from dual. That will also gives you a same result, means 3 is there. So here we don't pass a column name here, but instead of passing a column name, we just give the different values. So you can also find out the maximum value out of given numbers by this way. So default table name is dual here. That is very important. And if we just if we don't write this dual table name, then also we can find out the same result here. That is 3 in this case. So that is a that are the different examples related to MySQL max function. I think now you are able to understand the concept of max aggregate functions in different aspects. So let us take a quick revision of all the terms which we learned in this video. First of all, aggregate function. Aggregate function is basically the function where the values of multiple rows are grouped together to form a single summary values. And these are the different aggregate functions in which we just learned maximum max function in this video. So the max function returns the maximum value in a set of values of an expression. And that is the syntax of a maximum function. Always use the select statement, then max, and then from after, and then from then and after that table name. These are the parameters. Where and distincts are the optional. But you must write aggregate expression or table names in your query. Then MySQL function example. So we take an example here. And the table name is employees here. So we have to find out the maximum income of all employees, maximum income of employees here using a table name employees. For that purpose, we just write select max income as maximum income from employees. Maximum function can also be used with where clause. If you want to specify, if you want to give a condition which must be followed, then this condition must be specified with where clause. And if we want to form a group, then group by clause should be used. After that, after the table name from employees, and if there is a condition related to the group, that condition must be given after given with the having clause. And if we want to find out a unique value, then distinct keyword should be used. And at last, if there are two query, inner and outer, first of all, inner query should be executed. That basically gives the input for outer query. So these are the examples of maximum function. I hope now you are able to understand the concept of maximum aggregate function, max aggregate function. Thanks for watching this video.